density versus graph, density and graphing of that. It's an analytical balance. It's much better than an open balance because it's enclosed and other factors like temperature and weather and air can affect it. And then the whole time you're doing this, you cannot move this at all. And you have to make sure the balance is completely clean before you start. Make sure you also tear it right before you start. And by checking the back, you gotta make sure the balance is level. Back right here. Now to start, we're gonna tear it. And I'm gonna measure the beaker by itself. 50 milliliters. Get about 30.37.
Come to your results under beaker, and you'll write 30.37.
And you'll come back, take it out. So make sure you tear it before you start. Pour some of the solution in here. Get down to eye level. And there's two little waves. That's a meniscus right there. You don't measure the top one. So that'd be about 27. As you can see right here. You have to make sure you're at eye level.
Now you
tear
it. No, you keep writing because I don't want to miss how pretty that is. I've already
get about 47.39. You write it under the mass transfer. Alright. Make sure you record all your data the whole time you're doing this. Now you remove the solution. Make sure your air is clean and everything. Pour the solution back. Clean up some kind of thing with the pencil.
Alright.
Now. Alright.
So should.
There is some uncertainty with this because while you are filling this up, liquid may have been in there, so this may not be the exact mass. And subtract it. Your results.
When you first measured this, it's the initial mass, which you get right there. When you put the liquid in there, you get the other number, which was 47.39. And the volume delivered is the eyeball from the meniscus. And when you subtract the mass total from the mass initial, you get the mass final, which in this case would be somewhere close to 17.09. And make sure air is clean and finished. Record all your data. We did it about 6 times in each one. And you're good.